welcome back to my channel. So today we're discussing a very interesting topic, a topic that I guess most of us love and some of us can't live without, and that is music. Now, you cannot deny the fact that music plays such an important role in our lives, and it's such a major mood shifter, right? Like it can just make you happy and sad and cheerful and gloomy, and it just brings about so many emotions within you. And this got me really interested in knowing that what is it about music that has so much of power to change our moods so instantly. And I did a little bit of research, and what I found out completely blew my mind, and I thought, why not share this with you as well? So let's just get started. Now, I'm just gonna get my artistic skills out, all right? Now, consider this to be our brain, all right?
What?
Wow. All right, I guess this is what they mean when they say pea-sized brain. So we all know that brain is like divided into various parts, right? There are different parts within the brain, and every part has a different function to perform. Now, music is said to be one such activity which actually invokes different parts of the brain. All right, so it's not just one part of the brain that gets activated when you listen to music. For example, this is the frontal lobe, okay? I'm just gonna call it Freddy because it's easy for me to remember him that way. Alright, now Freddy is responsible for planning, for your decision-making skills. When you're listening to music, it actually enhances your planning and decision-making skills. There can be situations when you're listening to music, it gives you this calm and soothing feeling. Suddenly you have these ideas that come up, or you couldn't make a decision and you're listening to music and it strikes that, okay, this is what you had to do. That is because music is helping Freddy to think more clearly, to kind of make decisions better. Coming a little bit below, this is where your cerebellum is. I'm just gonna call it Bella. Cute name, right? Okay, so Bella is responsible for the movement, for the, you know, when you're moving, when you are grooving to the music, for the coordination. So if you're listening to music and you suddenly see that you're nodding your head, you're snapping your fingers, you're tapping your feet, that's because Bella is got activated and she likes the music and she's grooving to the music, baby. Now, if you come slightly over here, there is a part called as amygdala. Now, why do scientific names have to be so difficult? Why can't they call her Amy? So I'm going to call her Amy. Now, Amy is responsible to, you know, link an emotion to that music. So when you listen to a music, you will notice that there is always an emotion that it invokes within you. There are some musics that can send shiver down your spines, or it can just give you goosebumps, or it gives you this feeling of happiness or sadness. That's because Amy is associating an emotion to that particular music. Similarly, there's something called as a hippocampus. I don't know where it is. Let's just consider it's here. Okay, and I'm gonna call it Harry. Harry actually reminds you of a memory that's associated with that music. So you will notice that maybe one music used to make you feel very happy at one point because Amy had associated that music with happiness. But now Harry comes into the picture and that music reminds you of a breakup. So Amy now feels that, no, this music is not happy, this music is sad because breakup is sad. You get the point? So different parts of the brain actually work in together to kind of understand and comprehend that music. Music is considered to be a drug, and do you know why? Because it also releases dopamine. Now, dopamine is a chemical that gets released when you're happy, when you're doing any pleasurable activity, or when you're having drugs, or when you're having sex. Dopamine is what gives you that heightened sense of pleasure. And music does the exact same thing. So if you have a healthy way of actually getting that heightened sense of pleasure, why not try that? So whatever I've just said is in fact just still at a conscious level. What if I told you that music is actually changing you as a person?
No way.
And no, I'm not making this up. There's a research to prove that. So there was a research that was conducted wherein people were asked to make a playlist of 15 songs that made them happy and 15 songs that made them sad. And after listening to happy songs, they were shown an imagery which had smileys of happy and sad faces. And it was noticed that they could spot more happy faces when that imagery was shown. And few people could spot happy faces even at spots where there weren't any smileys. You know what I mean? Similarly, when sad music was played, and after that, when the same imagery was shown, they could find more sad faces. And the same thing happened. They could spot sad faces even in places where there was no smiley. So this goes to prove that music is really impacting your mind so much that you begin to see things based on what you're listening. So pay close attention to the kind of music you're listening to, the lyrics that you're listening to, and don't go by what I'm saying. Like, try it and do it for yourself. Go to your playlist, check the type of songs that you're listening to and what are the lyrics actually telling you. What is it that you're feeding your subconscious mind? Are the lyrics really motivating you, really pushing you to achieve, really driving you towards achieving your goals? Or is your playlist actually talking about how lonely you are and how sad you are and how bad the world is? Because I did this to myself. I really paid attention to the lyrics that I was listening to, and I noticed that most of the songs these days are not really very uplifting. You know, they're not ideally very motivating. And that really impacted with how I looked at myself. And the moment I switched that, I noticed that there was a sudden change in my mood. I was very self-motivated and I did not look out for validation from the outside because I was getting the validation within me. So it really brought about a major shift in my mood and my behavior. And I thought it would be great to tell this to you all so that it can help you all as well. So do try it out, okay? Don't go by what I'm saying, but do try it out for yourself and create a playlist of music that you feel is going to be motivational, is going to be inspirational for you, is going to uplift you, is going to cheer you up, and listen to that continuously for 1 month and see how things are changing in your life and within you. And yeah, that's pretty much it for this video. I hope that was helpful. I hope you all found that interesting and fun. And if you all did like it, please do give it a thumbs up. And don't forget to share and subscribe to my channel. And do comment in below about how you thought about this video. I would love to hear from you all. So I will see you all again next week, guys, with a new video. Until then, let's always spread love, positivity, and kindness. Bye.